we dodged a bullet, I think. You know, the way we shot the ball, the way we left a ton of points on the board. But I will say our defense was good. I thought overall, really good defensive performance that saved us. Obviously, we left a ton of points on the board.
You doubled up your average free throw attempts in one night in this game, but how concerning were the missed free throws?
I don't know how that goes. I mean, we haven't shot free throws great all year, quite honestly, and a little concerning right now. We're not shooting the ball well from the perimeter either. So I will say, you know, we are driving it. You know, we made a a conscientious effort to drive the ball in the second half, obviously got rewarded at, you know, going to the free throw line.
It looks like you had a lot of good looks. I mean, a lot of them, I assume, were the shots that you wanted, just missing wide open
threes. Absolutely, but that comes to bite. You know, when you're leaving those points on the table, especially in the first half, we had a ton of open looks and couldn't convert them, wide open looks. And then I think in the second half, it was more the free throws, you know. Obviously, something happened there. I'm not sure what.
You've responded to a three-game losing streak, though, with a three-game winning streak now. So how promising is that?
Yeah, I think we all knew this was a big week for us, you know, but very important, you know, obviously with the two home games, and this was, you know, circled on our calendar, a game you have to get. So, mission accomplished. Now we have a bigger game Monday against a team we're competing with for a playoff spot.
Jared Allen with a double-double. I know you don't necessarily want your players getting technicals, but seeing his scrappiness, you know, what was your take on the aggressiveness tonight?
Yeah, I especially don't like Spencer getting technicals. So, that's a story for another day. But I thought Jared Allen was fantastic tonight. I thought John Collins is an absolute one of the most aggressive players in the league, athletic. He comes at you. I thought Jared did not back down at all and saved us with his offensive rebounding. Saved us with his finishing and the paint. Great game for him.
Is there anything tactically that you did? I mean, you were down, I think, 105, 101.
I think we used the zone a little bit. We blitzed Trae Young a couple times, double-teamed him. They still, you know, they got an open shot out of it, but, we didn't want him to shoot kind of in crunch time. So, but he made the right plays. You know, we were double-teaming him, and he threw it out. And, again, they had some open looks that they didn't convert.
What did you think of Spencer's defense on that last play?
Pretty good. Just getting it out of his hands. We were actually switching in that situation, and J.A. switched out on him. And Spencer still followed Trae Young when he was supposed to switch. So, you know how that goes. Like, I do not want that guy to score. And Joe helped on the backside when Collins rolled. That left Werder wide open. And I thought Vince got a good look. You know, he was open. Brody got a good contest. But, you know. Good play by them.
Speaking of Brody, he said that his slump was partly because of fatigue. Since he's been in the starting lineup, what have you seen in his resurgence?
I don't know what neighborhood he grew up in, Lafayette, but that's a tough neighborhood because that's a tough dude. Like, he, you know, he might not look the part. He looks like, you know, looks like a choir boy, good-looking, you know, choir boy. But he's you know, him and Collins were going at it all game. Two guys competing. He doesn't back down from ever anybody. And, you know, that's Rhodey from day one, like, no fear. He has no fear, and he doesn't fear the situation. I thought he hit a huge three off the dribble when we were really struggling. Couldn't find a bucket. Like I said, no, he's fearless.
He hit a ton of shots today, but it seemed like every shot he hit, they were on like a 6-0 or a 9-2 run every single time he hit a shot.
Right. He is, he's saving us a little bit right now. I think his play has been huge since we, you know, put him at the four spot. I think he's really responded well, and I don't think we win these games without him.
And if there's been a common denominator, it's been the improvement of the defense over the last three games in general, hasn't it?
Yeah, I thought another solid, really solid defensive performance tonight. The rebounding, I don't know. I didn't look at the stats. I still feel like that's an Achilles heel. I just feel like we're making teams miss, but not coming up with the rebound. But listen, they're top five in the league in rebounding. Very, very athletic team.
Coach, obviously, you know, it's been a while since you've been here, and it's a whole different group on the floor. But when you see the night that John Collins and Trae Young had tonight, what do you see in the future of this?
I see a bright future for them. They got some really good young players. I love that they surrounded them with some veteran guys, you know, Bays and obviously Vince. Like, you know, that's similar to the model we had, you know, get high character guys, young guys that are willing to get better. Lloyd's doing a great job, you know, helping those guys improve. You know, that team's going to be a force in the future.